Here is our bread. This is our coat. Approximately, here is our Diane Zephyr love sketch. The Diane Zephyr is developed into two major parts. Part 1 is the thalamus. Part 2 is the hypothalamus. We are going to talk about number 1, thalamus. The purpose of the thalamus is to regulate things. What things? Like blood pressure. Feet grab on the right. What's blood pressure? The body requires that there be a certain amount of blood. There is a pump through the body at all times. And at a certain rate of speed, too. Medical personnel will generally call this blood pressure. Now, let's say the blood pressure in the body begins to rise. Okay. Not precipitously, but gradually. But you say to me, Doctor, what would cause that? Okay, let me give you an example. Let's say patient X. Let's call him Bob. Bob decides to eat too much salt with dinner. Feet grab on the right. The dinner was great, but now the salt absorbs lots of water in Bob's bloodstream, and the end result of this absorption is an expansion of the blood. Like this. Now, Bob has a gravel valve flowing through his veins. An expanded volume of blood is coursing through Bob's veins. The pressure of blood on Bob's system has just increased, which is to say that Bob's blood pressure had just risen. Bob's thalamus can now react to this in one of several ways. It can contact something called the parasympathetic nervous system. It said, "Oh my God, blood pressure has increased. Quick, do something." The parasympathetic system says, "Okay, I will dilate the walls of all the arteries, making them wider. That way, there will be more room for the blood and less pressure on each word throughout the whole body," which is to say that blood pressure will decrease and will return back down to normal. And that's another function of the thalamus. It maintains homeostasis, normal operational levels of body function, homeostasis. Normal operational levels of body functions. So, let's keep this short and to the point. So long from Dr. Tom in Ulsan. Bye bye.